Jesus said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. I invite us to confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Together,
most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly loved ourselves as we ought. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord, mercy receive the prayers of your people who call upon you, and grant that they may know and understand what things they ought to do, and also may have grace and power faithfully to accomplish them. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
O Creator and Giver of life, who prompted your mother, Maria, the glory and give her an example of service to the suffering and poor unto death. Teach us to love Christ in our neighbor, and thereby battle injustice and evil with the light of the resurrection. We pray this through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, in glory everlasting. Thank you.
A reading from the Word of God written in the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Woe to the shepherds who destroy and scatter the sheep of the pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, concerning the shepherds who shepherd my people. It is you who have scattered my flock and have driven them away, and you have not attended to them. So I will attend to you for your evil doing, says the Lord. Then I myself will gather the remnant of my flock out of all the lands where I have driven them, and I will bring them back to their fold, and they should be fruitful and multiply. I will raise up shepherds over them who will shepherd them, and they shall not fear any longer or be dismayed, nor shall any be missing, says the Lord. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up for David a righteous branch, and he shall reign as king and deal wisely, and shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In his days Judah will be saved, and Israel will live in safety. And this is the name by which he will be called: the Lord is our righteousness. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the churches.
Thanks be to God.
Our appointed psalm for today is Psalm 23. Found on page 612 in the Book of Common Prayer. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want.
He makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters.
He revives my soul and guides me along right pathways for his name's sake.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You spread a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup is running over.
Surely your goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark, the 6th chapter, beginning at the 30th verse.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
The apostles gathered around Jesus and told him all that they had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away to a deserted place all by yourselves and rest a while." For many were coming and going, and they had no leisure even to eat. And they went away in the boat to a deserted place by themselves. Now many saw them going and recognized them, and they hurried there on foot from all the towns and arrived ahead of them. As they went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them, because they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. When they had crossed over, they came to land at Gennesaret and moored in the boat. When they got out of the boat, people at once recognized him and rushed about that whole region and began to bring the sick on mats to wherever they heard he was. And wherever he went, into villages or cities or farms, they laid the sick in the marketplaces and begged him that they might touch even the fringe of his cloak. And all who touched him were healed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
I speak in the name of God, whose Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Apart from the readings that we shared in today, which reflects on Sunday's readings, today we also celebrate the life and witness of Maria Skobtsoba, you know those funny names, okay? But she was, I never want to call her, like, yes, David says, she was to me like a person who moved about and trying to get God's word into it. And we are told that as she moved from Russia to Europe and to the USA, that she started convents and orphanages to help those persons who were in need. She went through much challenges, and eventually she died on Holy Sunday in the year 1945. Where she was sent to the gas chamber. She was married on two occasions. Her first husband had died, and she married a second husband who was a judge that she appeared before. Eventually, he agreed to divorce her so that she could continue this little ministry that she started. Today we read the readings and say that were assigned for our proper 11b. And as we look at the reading, we did not use this reading on Sunday, we used the reading from Sunday. The reading from the prophet Jeremiah chapter 23. Where it talks about the restoration after the exile. And then in the text he's talking about, he says, "Woe to the shepherds who destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture," said the Lord. So you know exactly what was going on. That the shepherds were not doing what they were supposed to do. And as a result, they are being punished. There are today some shepherds, as we would want to say, that a one-eyed man is king in a blind man land. There are shepherds today who are misleading, and you can't really can't call them shepherds, but they're herders. Misleading congregations, playing on their emotions, and you know, people may not know better, and so they come again on a weekly basis. And you will hear someone say, "But I don't remember getting anything over there. I got some malaria, yes, but I don't remember anything else." As a result, the sheep are scattered, and they go and look for other places to graze. And when that happens, you see people that tend to blame everyone for every other situation. But the text in Jeremiah concludes by saying, "The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up for give it a righteous branch. He shall reign as king and deal wisely, and shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. Here, the topic perhaps could be speaking about Solomon, or could be speaking about Jesus. Being prophetic, if you know that Israel was saved, that the world be today as well, we were saved through this righteous branch that came out of David. How can we today as shepherds use this righteousness that is being bestowed upon us in the land in which we are called to manage, and in the land, I mean, not only the physical land where we grow crops and so on, but the people who exist in the land, whether it's in the form of education or in business or some a form of commerce, how we of the righteous branch are part of the building up of the kingdom of God. In these days, we have a mandate trying to help the saved Judah and the saved the Israel of today. Being so far, we are called to share the truth of God. And as in the gospel reading, as many others came to Jesus, whether on mats or whatever, Jesus reached out to them. How much reaching out are we doing today? And if so, how sustainable we are in reaching out to others? We have been given a mandate. And yes, in being given the mandate, God has equipped us for the task in which He has called us to execute justice and righteousness in this land and in every land in where we will be shepherds. Amen. I invite us to stand as we say the Apostles' Creed, and that those of you at home found in the Book of Common Prayer on page 103. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. In our prayers today, in the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for the diocese of the Immaculate, the Church of Nigeria, the Anglican Communion, just province. In the world cycle of prayer, we pray for the people of Bolivia. And in the ecumenical cycle of prayer, we pray for the members of the Metropolitan Community Church.
For the Holy Church of God.
For the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with truth and love, and be found without fault at the day of your coming, we pray to you, our Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our presiding bishop, Michael Bruce Curry, for retired Bishop Edward Ambrose Dunn, for the Ecclesiastical Authority of the Diocese, the Standing Committee, all bishops and other ministers, the clergy and laity of this diocese, and for all the holy people of God. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your glory. Pour out your spirit upon all flesh and hasten the coming of your kingdom. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our division may cease and that all may be one as you and the Father are one. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it will preach the gospel to the ends of the earth. Today we thank God for the imminent and continued progress of the Bell Tower Project. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may rule among nations and people. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in positions of public trust, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord,
have mercy. For all who live and work in this community, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For a blessing upon all human labor and for the right use of the riches of creation, that the world may be free from poverty, famine, and disaster. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, the homeless, and all who suffer, especially today, we lift up before God Victor Warren, Barry Billing, Hollis, Winnie, Monica, and Bernard John. Monica and Bernard, Jacob, John, and all those who have asked for your prayers of healing, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our enemies and those who wish us harm, and for all whom we have injured or offended, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have commended themselves to our prayers, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being free from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health, we pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all who have died in the communion of your church, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints, they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. We remember today the families of the late Harold Thompson, Karen Williams, Vanessa Ryan, and Victor Mike. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For yours is the majesty, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
At this time, I invite you to continue to say the prayer during your continue.
Almighty and everlasting God, Lord of heaven and earth, grant unto us your suffering people protection against hurricanes, earthquakes, tsunamis, and other calamities, that in tranquility of weather,
we may rejoice in the comfort we desire, and may always make right use of your bountiful goodness. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, before our needs are known before we ask, help us ask all your accords to your will. And those good things which we dare not, or in our blindness, cannot ask, grant us for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Sisters and brothers, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with your spirit.
I appeal to you, brethren, by the mercies of God, to present yourselves as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Praise God from whom all blessings flow.
Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above in heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Blessed are you, O Lord, our God, Creator of all things. Through your goodness, you have given us this bread, this wine, this money, our human labor.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them to the Lord.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father, almighty Creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, in fulfillment of his true promise, the Holy Spirit came down from heaven, lighted upon the disciples to teach them and to lead them into all truth. United peoples of many tongues in confession of one faith, and giving to your church the power to serve you as the royal priesthood, and to preach the gospel to all nations. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices and angels and our angels, and with all the company of others, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy,
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 holy.
Holy
Lord, God of all the light, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We give thanks to your God for our goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation. In the calling of Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil, and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took place. And when he had given the thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took a cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine, We pray, your gracious God, to send down your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood in the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things under subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with St. John and all your saints, we may enter the heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of all salvation. By him, and with him, and in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are all the same. Our Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins
as we forgive those who sin against us.
Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
For many a one body, because we also share in this one bread.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Yet then we remember that Christ died for you and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Yeah.
Christ glorified, and give us life and health and salvation. Send your Holy Spirit to our as your holy apostles anointed many that were sick and healed us. Send your those who in faith and repentance receive this holy sanctuary and made for through Jesus Christ, for this and live to be the Holy Spirit, one God, the Lord of the Lord.
Amen.
Give you that victory of life and peace. People in the area to pray for you both now and forevermore.
Amen.
As you are utterly augmented with this glory, I show me our Heavenly Father, grant you the inward anointing of the Holy Spirit. I take great mercy, may He forgive you your sins and release you from suffering, and restore you to wholeness and strength. May He deliver us from all evil, preserve us from all good, and bring us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Loving God,
we give you thanks for restoring us
to your goodness, by nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of
Christ's body and blood.
Send us forth your people, here and with you, for love to the world, and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. And the blessing of God, Almighty Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Please be seated for a moment. Just a few notices. We first want to thank you for sharing with us today in this act of worship. We invite you to join us on Sunday morning at either 7 a.m. and then again next week. Wednesday.
Tomorrow
we'll be for our service for the late Carol
Thompson
tributes. Sorry, not tomorrow. Forgive me, please. The service is to be on Friday. Service will be on Friday. Tributes at 9 a.m. And service
at 10 a.m. So let me repeat that. Yes, for the service for the power. Thompson will be on Friday. Service at 9 a.m. The service at 10 a.m. We encourage you to continue to support the mission and ministry of St. John. As we are tithing an offering, especially at this time when we started with our restoration, and we want to complete this phase one, we want to complete phase two in October, and we ask you for your, not only for your prayers, but your financial support in this effort in raising another $120,000 and reach out to all the parents that they, that, you know, that could assist us in making sure that this aspect of restoration is completed. During the month of August, there will be one service on Sundays at 8:30 a.m. Ranger services will continue on Sunday. We all say together a prayer of self-dedication. Almighty and eternal God,
so draw our hearts to you, so guide our minds, so fill our imaginations, so control our wills, that we may be wholly yours, utterly dedicated unto you, and then use us, we pray, for you as you will, and always to your glory and the welfare of your people, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Live without fear. Your Creator has made you holy, has always protected you, and loves you as a mother. Go in peace to follow the good word, and may the blessings of God be always with you.
Amen.
Amen.
Sisters, the worship is ending now, service again. Let us go forth into the world proclaiming the good news that Jesus Christ is alive and love.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.